Melo B.
Hey yo, what's crackalackin', everybody? Your boy Bongo's back, and today I have a very special video for you guys. You guys have been enjoying my giant DIY so much. The feedback is remarkable. So I thought to myself, why not make another one? So today we are making another DIY giant something. So if you guys can just take a look at the stuff behind me, you might be able to guess what's going on back here. Today we are making a DIY giant cheeseburger. Put your head top, what? It is gonna be one hell of a cheeseburger. We're gonna mix it up from the ground up ourselves. First things first, I gotta give a huge shout out to my boy, Ryan Swayze, behind the camera.
Swayze, baby.
You already know what it is. Your boy Swayze's in town, and here, we have to make a quick video for you guys. Before we get started, I need you guys to go down, smash that thumbs up button. Guys, I've been asking for way too little likes. Last video, I asked for like 9,000 likes. It's over 50,000 likes right now. So, this video, I'm gonna ask for 10,000 likes, guys. 10,000 likes. I trust in the Mongolians. I think we could crack 10K likes. So let's smash the like game, guys. 10K, that's easy. And of course, if you're new to the channel, please make sure you subscribe. Check me out on all these social medias. Everything will be in the description below. Without further ado, let's get into this DIY. So to get started with your DIY cheeseburger, obviously we have to make our patty. So I went over to the local butcher shop. I got myself over 5 pounds of ground beef. You see me with the ground beef, mom. You see me with the ground beef, B. So like I was saying, I got over 5 pounds of ground beef. So let's get started in making our patty. Guys, this is the part where we're gonna get a little dirty, so you know what time it is. Time to take off the jewels, yeah? Yo, take off my jewels, B. All right, guys, so let's get started. First things first, we wanna take our ground beef. We're taking all of it.
Yeah.
Here. One bag.
Yeah.
Two bags.
Another one.
Yeah.
Come on.
Here. All right, guys, now that you got your ground beef in the bowl, guys, I'm just using a metal bowl. This is probably gonna be the easiest thing to mix with. You wanna take all your ground beef, you wanna take your eggs, all right? We're gonna be using 3 eggs for this DIY. Since we're using such a large amount of beef, we're using 3 eggs for this one. So guys, nice and easy, crack your eggos.
Here, one-handed champ, there, here.
Like I said, guys, we're gonna be using 3 eggs,
here. Here.
All right, guys, once your eggs are in the bowl, you want to take some breadcrumbs. So we're just going to open up these breadcrumbs here, and we're going to sprinkle a bunch in. Guys, measuring obviously makes this DIY a lot better, but you know your boy Bongo, he's a fucking pro expert at cooking, so I'm just going to sprinkle in some.
Yo, Swayze, yo, there's jokes.
All right, guys, so that's about enough breadcrumbs. I used about a quarter of this container. So once the breadcrumbs are in, we are ready to start adding a little spice. We want to take some black pepper, and we're just going to grind that black pepper right on top of its head top. Here. Guys, we want about a teaspoon of black pepper, like a full teaspoon, so we're gonna be going at this for days. Here. Yo, Swayze, bro, there's jokes. I'm trying to film a video here. What's wrong with this guy? All right, guys, so you guys wanna take your salt. I actually got a fresh pack. You just wanna sprinkle some salt just like that. Make it nice and salty here. All right, we'll put this guy on the side, guys. Now, it is time to get a little bit messy. So like I said, we took the jewels off, jerk. Roll up the sleeves. It's time to get a little bit dirty. So don't be shy. Stick your hand right in here. Are you ready, Swayze?
I'm ready, Bongo.
Yeah, I'm gonna turn this light on still. Here. Like I was saying, guys, our patty is all ready to be mixed. Get in there nice and dirty here. Guys, we wanna go at this guy for about 5 to 10 minutes to make sure all the ingredients are nice and mixed. As you guys can see, there's still some dry ingredients on the bottom, so we wanna make sure that we're actually mixing it pretty well. All right, guys, so we've mixed the ground beef up. As you can see, look at that consistency, guys. So that is now ready to become a DIY giant beef patty. So here we go. What we need is a 9-inch pan. That's what I'm using here, guys. Look at it, it's bigger than both of my hands put together. This is gonna be one big patty. All right, guys, so what you wanna do is you actually just wanna grab a bunch of patty beef, put it in the tray and start lining up this tray with the beef patty. You guys want to push all the meat to the sides just like I'm doing right here. So it's really easy, guys. This stuff isn't really hard to maneuver. Grab some more, plop it down. Here we go. You just want to press up on the burger and make sure that you're filling the entire pan. Now, guys, notice how I'm making a little bit of a crust on the side. I'm kind of making it look like a pizza dough right now, and you will see why. I have a huge surprise for you guys. So as soon as we're done this first layer, we can actually even grab a little bit more beef patty to just reinforce the bottom layer. So we're just gonna blend this in a little bit more. All right, guys, so just like that, as you can see, I put a sufficient amount of beef into the tray. I'm building up a little crust, and guys, I have a huge surprise for you. This isn't just a cheeseburger DIY, this is a stuffed burger. All right, we're gonna be putting cheese in the middle of our patty. You're welcome. I'm gonna be showing you how to build a DIY giant stuffed stuffed cheeseburger, all right? So, back to my pan. As you guys can see, I built a little bit of a crust, and I'm gonna press this guy down. What I'm doing here is I'm actually building a platform for where I'm gonna be putting my cheese. And now it's time to slice up some cheese and put it right in the middle of the patty. All right, guys, so we have a brick of marble cheese here. What we're gonna do is we're actually just gonna grab a knife. What we wanna do is we wanna cut out thin slices of cheese and start putting it in our patty. So there's our first slice.
Another one here.
So we wanna continue doing that until the inside of our patty is completely full of cheese here. And now that is our cheese filling in our DIY giant stuffed cheeseburger. So once you've laid down your cheese in your burger, you guys can now put the tapas on top of your burger. So go back to your ground beef and grab some more beef here. And what we wanna do, guys, easy as that. We're fusing the top layer and the bottom layer together. You see how now I'm building a stuffed burger vibe. So what we wanna do is we just wanna press that excess meat all over. All right, we wanna fuse the bottom layer and the top layer together, all right? Grab some more beef. Slam it down, guys. You wanna be extra generous with this guy. We're just gonna continue stuffing the tray with the beef until the tray is fully loaded with our beef patty. All right, guys, so as you can see, I've loaded my tray with my patty. There is cheese in the middle of this. So, guys, Bongo's Kitchen, we are efficient, we are organized. You think I'm a rookie? I've already started preheating the oven. So we preheat the oven to 375. It should be right around ready to go. Once you've completed your patty and you've put all your beef in the tray, you've stuffed that bitch with some cheese, it is ready to go in the oven, Oz. So here it goes, slide it right in. You guys wanna give that guy 30 to 35 minutes to fully cook. So we'll check up on it when it's right around ready and we'll catch you guys then. Alrighty, guys, so since our patty is in the oven, it's cooking up, it's taking its time. Guys, Bongo's Kitchen, efficiency, organization, you already know. It is time to prep our toppings that we're gonna be putting on our burger. So now that we're done being dirty, we can put the duels back on, yeah? Put my duels back on. All right, so what we're gonna do is we're actually gonna top it off with some lettuce, some tomato, some onion, and some pickle, everyone's favorite toppings. I don't know about you, comment down your favorite toppings that you like to put on your cheeseburger. I personally like all sorts of toppings. So let's start with cutting our lettuce and we'll move on to the other toppings. All right, guys, so we have a head of iceberg lettuce. Like I was saying, guys, I love my toppings, so I'm gonna be cutting up a bunch of toppings. But when you are working with iceberg lettuce, little life hack, if you ever wondered how to get this bottom piece off, all you have to do is line it up on your cutting board and just smash it, and then this should pop out ever so easily. Boom, there. All right, guys, so what we wanna do is we actually wanna take our knife, all right? We're gonna grab our head of iceberg lettuce, and what we're gonna do is we're just gonna chop up thin slices of lettuce, and that's what we're gonna be using as our topping for our burger. As you can see, guys, it's nice and neat, all right? Just take your time with this one. Guys,
be safe, okay? You don't wanna cut your hand very little, so be sure that you're safe.
Tomato bay.
All right, guys, so like I was saying, I enjoy my toppings. So we got started on our tomatoes. We have a couple slices. Essentially, what we want to do here is we just want to continue slicing our tomatoes, guys. You want these guys to be relatively thin, but not too thin. So I'm just going to go with this size slices, all right? So we have our first tomato down. So now we're just going to chop up our second tomato here, here, here. So that's gonna be our tomatoes for our burger. Next up on the list, we wanna add some onions, all right? So guys, I got one big old white onion. What I'm gonna do here, again, with the life hack, what you guys wanna do to peel an onion, cut one end, cut the other, cut one line down the middle, and then that should pop off your first layer of skin. And then boom, there you go, you got a nice clean onion. So now we got our onions, we got our tomatoes, we got our lettuce. We're just gonna add these guys all to the plate here. So our topping plate is ready to go. We're still giving this burger a little bit more to cook. Guys, I didn't pickle my own pickles, but save your money, B. I got Ryan Sweet in the camera. Yeah, get the fuck off my set, bro.
What are you making today?
We're making a big burger, bro. Ready. It's almost done. Perfect timing, John. You actually interrupted at the perfect time.
Bro, that looks amazing.
Stop trying to... I had to taste it.
You get a bite. You get a bite. All right, guys. So the burger is almost ready. Like I was saying, now it is time to prep our bun. We're going to put some butter on it, give it a nice little crisp buzz. You already know what it is. Let's check up on our burger one more time. Here we go. Whoosh. Oh, my God. Guys, that looks like it's almost ready to roll. All right. Let's not waste any more time. Guys, we went to Rideau Bakery out in Ottawa. They hooked it up. They actually actually made me pay for it. They really hook it up. So we got this big old bun, right? Now, Swayze and I were doing some investigative research. This is a pretty big bun, but our patty is pretty friggin' big, as you guys can see. So we started to scheme up a plan. We're like, yo, how are we gonna make this bun bigger? And not necessarily bigger, we wanted to fit a big burger in between. So Swayze came up with the genius idea of, and which you guys should subscribe. So like I was saying, Swayze came up with the genius idea of doing this. We're gonna take our bun and we're actually just gonna cut a little slice off the bottom, Oz. What that's gonna do is that's actually gonna maximize the bun up here to make the top of our bun. So we're just gonna take this little layer off. Be careful when you're using a knife. You don't want to mosh up your hand up here. So guys, continue with this. Make a nice cut. That is going to serve as the top of our bun, guys. So that's going to be the top of our bun, all right?
No.
There's jokes. All right, guys. So we're going to take our second bun. And what we're going to do with the second bun is we're actually just going to slice a bit off the top, Oz. So we're actually just going to take the muffin portion off. Now, notice how this slice is thicker than the one we just tossed out. So we're going to make a nice cut up. Mosh up the scene up. So continue with your cut. And here you go. Boom, bam. Thank you, Swayze, for helping me out.
No.
Alright guys, so now that we have the bottom of our bun, we have the top of our bun. It's an extendo bun, B.
DIY burger head.
DIY Bongo Burger. Alright guys, all jokes aside, let's check up on our burger. Let's see what's going on in this oven. Yo, what's up? You want beef? You guys want beef? I gave you beef. What? Huh? You guys want to grab an oven mitt here, all right? And carefully take out your, oh my. Bro, who's the food DIY guy?
Me.
Who's the food DIY guy?
Me.
I said, who's the food DIY guy?
She is.
All right, so we've taken our burger out. Guys, as you can see, our patty is nice and bubble up. It looks pretty freaking good. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna grab a plate. We're gonna put our plate on the side, Oz, right here, all right? We're gonna take a handy dandy, whatever you call these things, and we are gonna try to scoop up our burger. Yay. Oh, okay. Here.
Shit,
bro.
You want beef, huh?
Alrighty guys, now that the burger is out, we're actually gonna give it a little bit to cool, but we are not wasting any time here. Guys, now it is time crunch. We wanna make sure that everything adds up at the end. So, you guys wanna grab your margarine, grab a butter knife, take some margarine. You guys wanna put a healthy portion of margarine on your bun-oz. Another one on the top side of the bun-oz. Don't be shy. This is gonna give it extra crunch on the bun. It's just gonna make it taste nice and savory. And this is what we're gonna do. We're gonna put our bun-oz in the oven, Oz, all right? We haven't turned off our oven yet. We're gonna give that guy 5 minutes to crisp up. Efficiency, organization, that's going. Our patty's out. Now we gotta make a move on the cheese top. Open up your cheese slices and start laying down your cheese on your burger. Guys, this should be relatively simple. Open up the cheese, boom, another one. Keep doing that until your patty is completely covered in processed cheese, because you know we fucks with the healthy shit, all right? As you can see, we've made a nice circle of cheese around our patty. Now this last slice is just gonna cover up the top, Oz. This little bald spot that we have here, we don't want that bald spot. So we're gonna take this, slap it down, bam, bam, here we go. Now let's check up on our bread. Okay, it's getting a nice little toast. As soon as it's a little bit toasted, you see what I did there? Flick of the wrist. Turn that shit to broil low, all right? That's gonna make your top element broil the shit that's in your oven, all right? It's gonna give it a nice little crisp on the inside. It's gonna look amazing. We've prepared our workstation, okay? So we got our cutting board. I got some mayo. I got some ketchup. I got all the toppings that I prepared earlier. And of course, Major Keeler, great value dill pickles. Save your money. No! So we got our great value pickles here. Let's give these guys a taste.
Amazing.
All right, guys, let's check up on our bun. Amazing, nice and toasty, like I expected it. Let's take that guy out. Another one. Turn your oven off, guys. Make sure, Major Keeler. Look what we have here. So we got our bottom bun, we have our top bun. Now it's time to start spreading some condiments. We're gonna take our mayonnaise. We're gonna open this guy up, and we're actually just gonna write your name here. Bong. go here.
We want to take our handy dandy ketchup.
Write your name. Bongo.
It is time to top our burger. We want to grab our lettuce.
Make a nice bed of lettuce.
Now, guys, what you want to do, you want to fill up your burger with those tomato slices. Look how beautiful that is.
This is turning out incredible.
Now that we have our lettuce and tomatoes on, it is time to pick up this DIY stuffed giant patty. We're gonna put the patty on top like that. As you can see, guys, the cheese started to melt on top. Look how amazing that looks.
Guys, what we're gonna do now is we're gonna take our onions, all right? We're gonna top it off with some onions. Make sure you go with the flow here with the cheese, and then you can stick some in onto the cheese. Beautiful. We're gonna go around, put some more onions on that. Maybe we'll put some of these baby ones in here. I like my onions, guys. Some pickles. Grab as many pickles as you like, and then just lie them up like so.
Is that a giant burger? Is that a giant burger, baby?
Ooh, baby.
Is that a giant burger?
Are we ready to put the crown on this guy?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Slow motion that, boy.
Here we go.
Oh. My goodness.
Bro?
Guys, I can't believe this burger turned out the way it did. Honestly, this is incredible. Definitely the biggest burger I've ever fucking made in my life. It was my first time trying it, worked out perfectly, but you never know till you taste it, all right? So it is time for the epic DIY giant burger taste test. All right, guys, so it is time to taste test this burger.
Hold on, hold on, hold on, what are you doing?
I'm gonna cut it.
Why?
Cause I'm gonna cut a slice off.
Nah, bro.
Oh, it's a burger, bro. That's right.
It's a burger. Who cuts a burger?
Bro, what was I thinking, bro?
It's not no chocolate bar.
Yeah. Bro, honestly, before I do this, I need you to feel how heavy that is.
Oh my goodness, bro. This is making me hungry.
Is that not crazy?
Bro, I'm starving now.
Ooh-wee. All right, here we go. Here goes nothing.
Yeah, another one.
Oh my God. Look at that.
I swear to God, it tastes unreal.
Wow. Swayze, you ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
All right, it's your boy Swayze, baby. Swayze Nation, stand up.
Oh, you can't even hold it like that.
Bro.
Oh my God. That burger legit was beyond words. It's too much. Look, like, you don't realize how big it is when you realize McDonald's patty is this big. You got something to compare it to. This thing is this big. Unreal, Mongo. You did a good job.
Yeah, thanks, bro.
But you know what they should do?
Huh?
Go to my channel and subscribe to your boy, Swayze, baby. Guys, honestly, huge shout out to my boy, Swayze Nation. You already know.
Love you guys.
Make sure you go check out his channel. Subscribe to your boy, Swayze, baby. If you're new to Swayze's channel,
Swayze, baby,
comment down below, done, and I will follow you back. Comment your Instagram, your Twitter, I will follow you guys. So make sure you go check out Swayze's channel. Comment done down below, and I will be following a bunch of you guys.
I'll kill him. I'll kill him, bro. Did you guys take a bite yet?
Yeah.
Bro, well, where?
Holy, bro.
Jeez, who's mans? Yeah. I'm hoping these are as good as the chocolate bars. Real talk.
Bro, it's a burger. Put it that way.
Mmm. Not blessed.
You heard it here first, guys. DIY giant motherfucking cheeseburger. All right, guys. So remember how we stuffed the patty? We actually still haven't even looked inside. The boys have been biting at it for a while. We're actually just going to cut into it to see how things turned out. So let's just cut in here. All right, let's see. Moment of truth, guys. Oh, dear. Oh, dear. Guys, look at that cheese filling, B. What are you saying? Your boy's a DIY guy, bro. It is what it is. Honestly, catch me outside. How about that? All right, guys, thank you so much for watching this video. I had a great time making this DIY giant stuffed cheeseburger. It was amazing. It turned out incredible. It tasted great. It was juicy. It was everything you wanted in a DIY giant stuff Cheeseburger Thingy Majiggy. Huge shout out to my boy, Ryan Swayze. You already know what it is. Make sure that you go check out his channel. Subscribe to the man if you're not subscribed. And when you do, comment done below and I'll be following a bunch of you guys on Instagram and Twitter. Again, guys, make sure you smash that thumbs up button. Comment down below what kind of DIY, giant, whatever you guys want. And hey, your idea might make it on the channel. Again, thank you guys so much for watching this video. Until next time, take it easy. It's Monkey!